talk about Shastra. What is the definition of Shastra? Shastra is a authoritative documentation of certain theories and practices of any knowledge system. And that Shastric knowledge, this technique of debate and dialogue is very essential. Learned authors of Sanskrit Shastras were familiar with the fact that inquisitiveness is an essential state of mind, and that will be known to him through a question or a doubt put by that aspirant. In Sanskrit or in Vedic literature also, we find a term jigyasa for this inquisitiveness. In English, we used to say inquisitiveness, eagerness, keenness, or curiosity, but in the term jigyasa. Jigyasa is a term made of two words, gya and san. Desire to know. Desire to know is called jigyasa. So exactly this term should be used, and the person who is having this attribute is called jigyasu. He is desirous to know. The question arises, who is desirous to know? The person who know something, or the person who know nothing, or the person who is totally knowledgeable? So generally we will find that if there is a question, that the person is not ignorant, fully ignorant about that subject, nor he is fully knowledgeable about that subject. He knows something, that is why he is asking a question. He thinks he does not know the subject exactly. Vidya, for Vidya he goes to Guru with a question. Robert Hume has said, earnestness of the search for truth is one of the delightful and commendable features of the Upanishads. The urge to realize the truth, then only he will be able to process the truth. It means there is some relationship between questioning and the curiosity. As again, there is a quotation from Einstein. He says, important thing is not to stop questioning. Curiosity has its own reason for existing. Greatest explorations and discoveries of present time or the ancient time, all were due to this curiosity only. The attribute gets attached with the human being right from the beginning of his life. As we all know, a child has a curiosity about language, the mother is speaking. And similarly, an elder person, as we are all senior, most of us are senior, so we are having curiosity about spirituality, what is this word, from why we are having this life, what is the purpose of life. So curiosity is the mother of any discovery, or mother of any attainment of achievement. Curious student asks several questions and do not settle down without answers. Level of curiosity that exists differ person to person. There may be questions who, when, how, where, what, and why are asked under such curiosities. An inquisitive person is not always ready to listen and learn, but it will lead to solution and investigation. It means when he is putting a question with curiosity, it means definitely he is very, very desirous to listen what teacher will say, what his achar will say. So generally, jigyasa arises to the person who is very, very keen to know, first thing. And the keenness will come only to a person who knows something, who is not totally ignorant. As here in this slide, you may say, first and the second point, if questioning is there, what is already known to the person will be clear. And secondly, what does he eagerly want to explore will be clear. The two things will be clear, what he knows and what he doesn't know. What he knows, already know, and what he want to know. What is the subject, what is the content of his approaching to an acharya or a guru. In another way, this here it is put like that. As in Sanskrit, we say agyani, ignorant, and jnani, who is knowledgeable. So curiosity will not arise to a person who is agyani, who doesn't know anything, to him curiosity will doesn't arise. And the person who know everything will not be curious about that subject. As a simple question here I can put, when I am coming to Dallas, someone will ask me, why you are going to Dallas? So the questioner know that I am going to Dallas and I have to do something. This much he knows. But he doesn't know why I am going, there is a conference and what is role, my role in that conference. So if a person doesn't know, I am sitting in the flight and he doesn't know who I am, where I am going, so he will not put a question. Or if he, my son knows everything, then he will not ask the question, where you are going, why you are going. So simply like that, both sides of that question are important. What is before, what is after. As in Sanskrit we can say, non-ignorant, he is not ignorant of the subject. He is neither ignorant, he is neither knowledgeable, he is not ignorant of the subject. He knows and he knows not. This slide can be skip over, as everyone knows Acharya and Antevasi, the old system of education was that student used to live with teacher, so constantly he can ask questions, he can live with him. And what was the goal of the teacher, that was of a higher level, from light, he has to go to light of knowledge from the darkness of ignorance. So this was the tamso ma jyotirgamam, ubhe me shriyam ashnyat, brahmacha kshatramcha. Then that knowledge should be implementation on our own system, our strength, our brilliance, all should be bright and glorious. So these were the objective of the learning and education. Jigyasu is the student, as has been told earlier. The second condition of that student is Vairagyavan. He should be non-attached to the other subjects. He should focus on the subject which he want to know. So two conditions are given, and this verse is coming from Mundaka Upanishad, and this is a very important verse I used to quote time to time. He should be Jigyasu and Vairagyavan, and on the other side, teacher should have all some qualities, and two conditions or two qualities of teacher is shown there. He should be Shrotriya and Brahmanishtha. Shrotriya means well-versed. The whole Vedic literature should be clear to him. Shruti should be clear to him. And Brahmanishtha, he should be focused on the subject, on the Brahma, on the attainment of higher knowledge. A highly advanced seeker needs a real master for himself. His two characteristics are Shrotriya and Brahmanishtha. And this is another mantra from Mundaka Upanishad, which says, if such teacher gets a student near him with a question, appropriate question, with the mannerism which is prescribed in the Vedas, how to approach to a student with the full curiosity, with whole disattachment, then it is the duty of the teacher that he should tell everything which he knows about that. He should not hide anything. And this is always with the teacher, that they never hide anything. And they tell everything to his student if he knows that subject. And the next slight condition is there. How many days he should tell that subject? Till he knows very well. There is no time limit. Ved yena shramam तस्मै सा विद्वान विधिवत उपसन्नः सम्यक् प्रशांताय समन्विताय ये नाक्त पुरुषम् वेद सत्यम् प्रोवाच तम् तत्वतो ब्रह्म विद्याम्. With dry critical marking it takes some time to read. So till he knows that subject, let him truly teach the Brahma Vidya by which the true or immortal Purush is known. Till that subject is known, he should teach him. Then conclusion can be taken here that curiosity works as a tool for the master. It is very important component for learning, for the understanding of teacher, that his student is able. He will be testing like that, he will be examining, and then he will explore that all knowledge which he has with himself. Inclination is there, attentiveness is there, no doubt now he will be listening all the facts very carefully. So questioning is very important, and curiosity is hidden behind it. I will only give three illustrations from three different Upanishads. So Mundak Upanishad, everywhere where when they are going to a serious dialogue, the student will be asking a question. He says, it is a very deep question. The whole mantra I am not reciting. Kasmannu bhagavo vigyate sarvam idam vigyatam bhavati. Kasminnu bhagavo vigyate sarvam idam vigyatam bhavati. What is that, O Lord, which being known, all these becomes known? We explained it the whole one period, this line. Kasminnu bhagavo vigyate is written in singular. It means the student or the Shaunak Rishi who is asking this question knows that there is only one thing. From that, multiple type of this word is coming on. So multiple word is universe is coming from one entity, one reality. This is the question. Kasminnu bhagavo vigyate sarvam idam vigyatam bhavati. Everything will be known if I will know that one thing. The question is clear, but the answer will be that one thing. And it means the student or the Shaunak Rishi knows definitely the multiple type of this universe is coming from one, that is the source, and he has no doubt. Our Rishi is never doubt in anything when they say it 100% they are true in their observations, in their declarations. So he is very clear that one thing is the cause of all this universe. And he wants to know about that one thing fully with all details. Because illustrations are given there by Shankaracharya, he says that if ocean will be known, all water, all waves, all sprinkles, all bubbles which are in the ocean will be known. If clay will be known, all things made of clay will be known. If gold will be known, so there is a cause and multiple effects of that cause. So simply he wants to know about Brahman, and that is Upanishad, and because Upanishads are called Brahma Vidya. In the Kathopanishad again, after two bones, Yamacharya, Nachiketa asked the third question, and that question again shows how much he knows and how he want, what he wants to know. He says, येयं प्रेते विचिकित्सा मनुष्ये अस्ति तेकं नायम् अस्तीति च एके एतत् विद्याम् अनुशिष्टस्त्वयाहं वराणामेश्वरस्तृतीयः. दिस इज माई थर्ड बून. आई वॉन्ट टू नो आफ्टर डेथ व्हाट हैपन्स. सम से इट लिव्स, सम से इट नॉट, सम से इट एग्जिस्ट, सम से इट डजंट एग्जिस्ट. इट मीन्स द क्वेश्चनर इज नो, द फैक्ट इज नोन टू द क्वेश्चनर दैट वेन देयर इज डेथ that something exists or not exists. That is the Atman. Atman is different from body. So all these things are clear to him. He want to only know about that Atman in detail. When seriousness of the disciple Nachiketas was tested by Yamacharya, he gives him many things he offers him in that in lieu of that question, but Nachiketas is not settled. Then finally he has to tell all Brahma Vidya, and that is Kathopanishad. In the Kenopanishad also, first verse is Kenishitam patati preshitam manaha ko prathamaha pranaha yuktaha. So again there is a question, willed by whom does the directed mind go towards its object? Being directed by whom does the vital force that proceeds all proceed towards its duty? By whom is that speech will the people utter? So firstly the questioner is knowing that these things are different from the consciousness which is inside. But the question, and secondly, he knows that it is a one entity, the same entity, not different directors are sitting in, one is in eye, one is in air, one is in prana, one is in manas, vachas. No, only one. So he wants to know that supreme directing power. Yes. And this component of curiosity for attainment of higher knowledge is widely approved in our literary traditions. Maybe philosophical text, maybe different types of text. As in the Rigveda is actually earlier than Upanishads. So there are so many questions found in different philosophical hymns, especially Kasmai Devaya Vishavidema, Koveda, Naveda, Nasadiya Sukta. So questioning is always in the Vedic verses. Upanishads we have already discussed. Yagvalka Gargi Samvad is in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. Maitri Samvad is in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. Then I will like to discuss this point, which is in Nirukta by Yaska. He says when all Sakshatkar Dharmana Rishya Babhu, rishis were revealed the knowledge in the verses, then they wanted to proceed from this earth. Then question was asked, who will tell us the meaning of the verses? Who will tell us the meaning of these Vedic verses, which are so deep and difficult? Then seers has replied, henceforth Tark will be your seer. Tark means or argument. Tarkam rishim prayacham. From now onward, you should consider argumentation as your rishi. Tark ko hi rishi samajhna hai. So this is very important narration we see in Nirukta. Kautil has elaborated this differently. Then philosophical texts are there, which are called sutra granthas, as in Mimamsa, as in Brahma Sutra. Everywhere there are sutra granthas, and for example, two sutra granthas we may refer. Mimamsa Sutra, it starts from Athato Dharma Jigyasa. Brahma Sutra starts Athato Brahma Jigyasa. So when they say Ath Jigyasa for Brahma, Ath Jigyasa for Dharma, Ath means something is known and something has to be known. So before and after, that term is underlined here. So what is known to the person, athato brahma jigyasa, ath means afterwards, now curiosity arises. So what afterward of what? It means he is knowing something. And that was explained by Vedanta philosophy, that was the karma kanda school of thought, and karmas and their fruits, all that now he has surrendered, and now he is approaching to Guru or Acharya for the attainment of Jnana or higher knowledge. So these sutras also begin for Jigyasa word. This is important slide, and it is taken from Yagyavalkya Smriti, where Jigyasa should not be shown, where curiosity should not be taken up. The list includes parents, guests, brothers, married ladies, in-laws, maternal uncle, an old man, a child, a patient, an acharya, the vaidya, and ritvik. It means with these persons, no debating, no discussion, no argumentation should be there. And the message is debate, for the sake of debate, should never appreciate it. It should be for some purpose. And a list is very unique in our Indian context, and we always, perhaps the persons who are genuine persons always follow all these things. We take care that we should not argue with our elders, etc. Finally, the conclusion is Vedic insight never failed to select an able scholar for the transmission of knowledge. This is proved by the preservation of extensive Indian intellectual traditions, which we have saved and we have preserved. Ramayana and Mahabharata continued this tradition. There are so many acharyas and shishyas. Their parampara is there. Shastrarth were patronized later also in the by the rich and the kings. This method of imparting higher learning is so accurate that there is no instance of its failure where the disciple could not understand or where he misused instructions. Clear vision and intense practicality are the real purpose of education. It means nowadays primary education should take care of curiosity, which should be generated in the student at that level. When that will be there, he will be himself start teach learning in other classes. When there is only memory and no assimilation, man becomes merely a storehouse. A quote from Vivekananda: education is not the amount of information that is put into your brain. If you have assimilated 5 ideas and made them your own life and character, you have more education. So educator should first develop curiosity in the learner or in the student. Thank you very much.